My brother and I, we lived in Montana for a while, man, and we actually owned a restaurant in Montana. Thanks. All right, it was a hot dog cart outside of a bar. We sold hot dogs to drunk people at 2 in the morning. That's like selling cake at fat camp. It's really easy. Here's the thing. I usually towed my cart home with my truck, right? But I got too drunk one night. I couldn't do that. So I decide I'm going to push it home. What could possibly go wrong? Pushing my hot dog cart down the road, 2:30 in the morning, okay? I see lights behind me, and I wave them. They don't go around. I'm like, so I wave again. Nothing. So finally, I pull off to the side of the road. I look behind me. I see red and blue lights, and I hear, sir, please pull the hot dog cart over. So I'm getting pulled over pushing a hot dog cart. All right. I felt like the kids on Super Troopers, like, I'm already pulled over. I can't pull over any farther. The cop used his lights and his horn to pull me over. I was moving at 1 mile an hour. He could have got out of the car and been like, hey, stop. So now I'm sitting there. The cop gets out of the car. Okay. I'm laughing hysterically. And he gets mad. He's like, what's so funny? I said, why'd you pull me over? He didn't say nothing. I said, I'll tell you why. It's because I'm a fat kid pushing a hot dog cart. And you think I stole it. Let's call it what it is, right? But the only thing I could think in my mind at that time was, how funny would it have been if I had ran from him? Better yet, how funny would it have been if I had ran from him and that made it on America's Wildest Police Videos? Do you guys know that show? Hosted by John Brunel? I think it'd go just like this. Bozeman, Montana. And this fat kid just wanted a hot dog, and now he's leading cops on a chase to this quiet mountain town. Reaching breakneck speeds of up to 2 miles an hour. And narrowly avoiding oncoming traffic. This hot dog cart evil Knievel needs to be stopped. With these dedicated officers in tireless pursuit, they're gonna use spike strips. Like a bullfighter placing the horns, the cops throw the strips and the tires on the cart pop like a pinata at a kid's birthday party. But there'll be no candy at this party. Only bratwurst. As the suspect's cart careens out of control and runs into a parked car, the officers swarm on him like a jungle cat. And now with the suspect in custody, this hot dog cart Casanova learn the hard way that if you want a picnic with the cops, they catch up. Thank you. You know, I was talking about not going to Reno. Here's another place you guys should never go, which Jersey. Okay? Jersey's the only place I've ever driven where litter will fly into your car. This is true. I was driving down the Jersey Turnpike. A McDonald's bag flew in my window. Okay. Now I did what any other good red-blooded American would do. I threw it back out the window. And then I got pulled over for littering. And now I got to explain to the state trooper that it's not my McDonald's bag. Not a fight I'm going to win is all I'm saying. Okay. Maybe if it was like a yogurt cup. Like, is this your yogurt cup? I'm like, nope. He's like, fair enough. I was telling you about being afraid to fly, man. Every time I tell people that, they say that I have an irrational fear of flying, okay? And that to me is stupid, because I don't believe an irrational fear is a fear of being 30,000 feet in the air in a metal tube going 800 miles an hour. I don't think that's irrational. I think like an irrational fear would be like, I'm afraid to walk out my front door because I'm pretty sure Bigfoot's waiting outside in a miniskirt and he's going to do weird stuff to me when I do, okay? That would be an irrational fear. But then everyone tells me the same thing. They're like, flying is safer than driving. And I'm like, that's bull. And here's how I know it, okay? Because you guys remember that plane that went down in the Hudson? Yeah. Right? That plane hit a goose and crashed. The plane hit a goose and it crashed. I hit a deer on my way here and still made it. Tell me that's safer is all I'm saying, okay? That's all I'm saying.